I I hope so. And this is our last performance, which is kind of sad. And whoever ended up with a palm stick, you get to keep it. It's a gift. And all the work and effort that all of these performers did, and all the work that's gone into this, from the lights to the sound to the music practices and everything, they worked really hard, and we want you guys to know that the whole thing is a gift that we want to give to you guys. And it's something that we want to help you guys. So a gift, we're kind of in that season, aren't we? Season of gift giving. No matter what you celebrate this time of year, gifts are at the central focus of it all. And gifts are pretty cool. I'm sure most of us here can think of a time that we received a pretty amazing gift. A gift that we know a lot of thought went into, a lot of time, a lot of effort went into that gift. Can anyone kind of attest to that, to the time when you got a gift that you knew that person put a lot of time and effort into that gift? Yeah? On the flip side, have you guys ever taken the time to really think about a gift that you want to give? You really put a lot of thought and effort into it, and just really spent all the time, and you were excited to give that gift to the person that you got it for. Yeah? It's pretty cool. A big deal with gifts is, the bottom line is, gifts and gift giving is a selfless, gracious way of showing deep affection for or towards the recipient. Listen to that again. Gift giving is a selfless, gracious way of showing deep affection and love to the recipient. And often gifts are given even if maybe they aren't deserved, right? Sometimes, you know, in the season, we're giving gifts, maybe even if they're not deserved. I believe that is the key to this time of year. That's a key to this season. People who believe in Jesus understand the gift that we have because of Christ coming to this earth. Now, at some point in everyone's life, you might have come across seeing this scripture. You might have seen this verse, John 3:16. If you know it, say it with me. For God so loved the world that he gave that whoever believes in him. Somebody's Sunday school teacher did a good job. So there we go. Now, what's the first part of that verse? For God so loved. Okay? What did I say earlier about gift giving? Gifts are a way of showing deep affection and love to the recipient. It says, God loved. For God so loved. He chose to create you. And he chose to create you for one reason. To be in a relationship with him. Kind of like when a married couple decides, hey, let's have a kid. And they bring a kid into this world so that they can be in a relationship with that child. I take it a step further, adoption. When a family or a person decides, I want to adopt a child into my family, they've chosen to bring that child into their family, to have a relationship with that child. It's a small picture of what God did, but the deal with God is he did it for perfect motives. Mm-hmm. He did it, and he created us for himself behind perfect motives and perfect intentions. Some view God as a judge, as a killjoy, that he's there to just kind of put his thumb on us. But this verse counters that, doesn't it? Because, again, wasn't he that verse saying, For God so loved. What's the rest of that? What's the next little section of that verse? For God so loved the world that he gave. That he gave. There's the gift. It is an undeserved gift. We give gifts even sometimes when they're undeserved. God gave an undeserved gift to us. What did God give and why? Well, he gave us Jesus, and he gave us Jesus to save us. To save us from what? Well, from ourselves. From our sin. We have one purpose in life. You, whether you believe it or not, whether you agree to this or not, you were really created for one purpose, and that is to be in a relationship with God. Mm-hmm. He chose to create us to be in a relationship with him, with our Heavenly Father, with our King. We chose otherwise. Our purpose in Christ was deteriorated when we chose to find our purpose in other things. So many people try to find their purpose in other things like work. We try to find our purpose in work, whether you're a banker, a coal miner, a veterinarian, a teacher. You might try to find your purpose in work. And anyone who's been around for any length of time realizes that in one way, shape, or form, that will let us down. We're going to feel defeated because that's not what we were created for. That's not our purpose. Yes, we want to do a good job at our work, but that is not our purpose. We don't find our purpose in our work. You will feel defeated if you try to find your purpose in your work. Some people try to find purpose in relationships. A best friend, a spouse, a parent to a child to a parent. They try to find their purpose in relationships on this earth. And over time, those are great things, but sometime or other, you're going to be let down in those relationships. I know I let my parents down. I know I let my wife down. And sometimes the choices we make leave us feeling regretful, regretting some of the things that we did. If we're striving to find our complete purpose in those relationships, it won't come to fruition because you were created for one purpose, to know God. Not know about God. Lots of people know about God. You look at the polls and people say, oh yeah, I believe there's God. They know about God. I'm talking about knowing God. Some people try to find their purpose in accumulating things. Cars, houses, musical instruments. My wife says, how many more guitars do I need? I always just say one more, just one more. But that's gonna leave us defeated because that is a purpose that will never be satiated. We can never get enough things. That's not our purpose. Sometimes people will strive to find their purpose in the next hit, in the next drink, in the next high. And often, well, most of the time, those leave us living a life of regrets because of the choices we made to try to find those next things, that next high, that next hit, leading us with a life of regrets. That will always happen until we realize that our purpose is to be in a relationship with God. All those vain pursuits, all those desires to find purpose in those things, the Bible, Scripture, it's called sin. And sin is what separates us from God. Those vain pursuits, striving to find our purpose in things other than God, that is sin. That separates us from God. That's why we need Christ. That's why Christ came and died on the cross. Wait. Rob, this is Christmas. Why are you talking about the cross? Well, you can't think about the cradle without thinking about the cross. Because they are one and the same. They are synonymous. Because Christ came to make our relationship with God feasible, to help us be forgiven of our sin, to help us be forgiven of the things that destroy us, because all those vain purposes will destroy us. A workaholic, an alcoholic, that can destroy us physically. In our relationships, we can feel destroyed emotionally. Divorce, broken relationships, leaving us for life and regrets. All those things will destroy us. The only thing that can make us right is by putting our trust in Jesus and by accepting Him as Lord and Savior to make that relationship with Christ, with God, right. That's the purpose of this Christmas season. That is our purpose in life, is to be in a relationship with God. There's one more part of gift giving we didn't talk about. I kind of hinted at it, but it's the acceptance piece. The joy of the gift cannot be completely celebrated and enjoyed unless the recipient actually accepts the gift. I don't know how many of you might have a gift in your closet that, oh man, I bought that and I intended to give that to somebody and it's still sitting in my closet. And that joy of giving that gift and that gift being accepted cannot be fully come to fruition until it is actually accepted. Let me say that again. The joy of the gift cannot be completely celebrated and enjoyed unless the recipient actually accepts the gift. So our verse was, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes will not perish, but have eternal life. We have to put our trust in Jesus. We have to accept that gift. The choice is yours to receive that gift. God chose you for a relationship with Him. Jesus chose to come to earth to die, to pay the price of the penalties of the destruction of our sin, to pay that price. All we have to do is choose to accept Him and to put our trust in Him as Lord and Savior. Our Heavenly Father chose to create us for Him. We have the opportunity to choose Him. We have the opportunity to be a child of the one true King.
Oh,
The enemy wants to keep you away from that. Regrets, defeat want to keep you away from it, want to hold you back. But God's desire is for you. All of us that are a part of this performance have put our trust in Christ as Lord and Savior. If that's something that you would be interested in doing, we love to talk to you. We will all be hanging out in the foyer after the performance. Again, we'll chat with you. If you want to have a better understanding of what it means to be a child of the Lord, true King, that is our goal. That's our whole purpose in a lot of this, in most of this, in all of this. As far as this church is concerned, maybe you don't have a church family. We would love for you to be a part of this church family here at Delta Christian Church. If you're looking for a home, if you're looking for someone, and a body of believers to love on you, to care for you, come and be a part of this. We'd love to have you here. We do have a few things coming up as a church. We have a kids' performance coming up next Saturday. We'd love to have you come and be a part of that. We have our Christmas Eve service. That would be on December 24th. And we'll be here at 5 o'clock. So love to have you come and be a part of that. We have a little ladies' Christmas tea coming up next Sunday about this time. So if you're looking for a church home, if you're looking for a place to just plug in, maybe this is the church for you. If you're looking to find out more on what it looks like and what it means to put your trust in Jesus, Lord and Savior, we'll be hanging out in the foyer. Thanks for coming. God bless. Good evening.